we are here at the NBA store in SM Mega Mall getting to chat with none other than White Chocolate, Jason Middleton himself.
Jason, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For joining us here and welcome to the Philippines.
Appreciate it. Thanks for having me.
All right. So, of course, we need to talk about basketball, your career. You spent championship with the Miami Heat, with the Sacramento Kings as well. How can you say your career has been with the NBA and how would you summarize all of that?
You know, I think I had a pretty long career for someone like myself. You know, I had a fun career, I think a successful career. You know, I was blessed to have a bunch of good teammates, every team that I played for, and some great coaches, Hall of Fame coaches, one in particular, Eric Spoelstra, which you guys are familiar with here in the Philippines for sure.
It's your second time in the Philippines, but you're looking forward to this time.
Yeah, I'm just looking forward to getting closer to the fans, you know, and things like that, interacting and getting to see some 3-on-3 games.
Right, that's for sure. Now, when it comes to your stay in the Philippines, I know you spent a couple of days. What have you enjoyed the most? Was it the experience, the food? What was it like for you?
The people. This is, like I said, this is the second time that I've been here, and the people are just so friendly. And it's crazy to me that there's this many White Chocolate fans this far away from where I grew up and stuff like that. But it's just, every time that I get a chance to come here, I'll be here for sure.
Playing with Hall of Famers Shaquille O'Neal, Dwayne Wade, Miami Heat Championship, Gary Payton as well. What does it take to win a championship?
It takes a lot, you know, and I think the journey to get to the championship, like the whole season, the practice, the training camps and things like that, that makes winning the championship worth its while, you know, because winning the championship is kind of, I don't want to say easy, but it's a lot less hard than practice and training camp and things like that.
That's true, right. When you talk about championship and making it big in the league, you know, sustainability aspect, you know, for you personally, what have you done? What did you do to be able to have that longevity part?
I mean, you really have to take care of yourself. You have to, you know, I mean, it's cliche to say, but you have to eat right, you have to get your sleep, you know, and do things like that. You can't be partying all the time and things like that. So, and you have to keep practicing too. I was telling the kids the other day that once you make it to the NBA, it's not like you can stop working. You know, it's really like you have to start over and just keep working just as hard.
And that's most important now because of the competition.
Of course.
Everybody's doing that.
Every year there's kids wanting to come into the NBA and trying to take these older guys' spots. So the older guys just have to keep working.
All right. So if just a parting shot, you know, basketball has evolved. Basketball has really been so competitive. What would be the best advice, the best things that you could leave to our audience to be able to reach an elite level?
I would just tell them, you know, just keep working hard and don't let anyone tell you that you can't do anything. If you really want to achieve something and you put in the time and the work and the practice, then the sky's the limit. Like I said, keep working hard and doing what you think you can do, and don't let anybody tell you anything.
Just a follow-up, of course, with the rise of social media, right? Everybody's so competitive. Everybody's maybe has a certain pressure.
Yeah.
It's definitely a factor.
Yeah, I think it probably does in some young kids' lives. That's a tough situation. I'm so thankful that I didn't have social media growing up because I don't think I think there's some good aspects about social media, but for the most part, for these young kids, I think it's taking their attention away from things that it should be on.
All right. Lastly, Jason, if there's anything that you'd like to say to Filipino fans?
Oh man, I just want to thank you guys for having me. And
there you have it. White Chocolate, Jason Williams right here on ABS-CBN. Jason, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For joining us here.
Appreciate it.
Welcome to the photo.
Thank you.